What are the strikes against a microkernel-based design? The first strike is the border crossing cost going between kernel and the user and vice versa. And this you have to do every time a user-level process makes a system call, you have to go through the kernel. That's the border crossing cost. So that is the first explicit cost that can be a strike against microkernel if this were to happen too often. The second strike against a microkernel-based design is address-based switches, with the assumption that each system service is living in its own hardware address space. Whenever an application needs any system service, that may involve the servers living above the microkernel having to talk to one another in order to provide that particular service that was requested by the application. And I mentioned that protected procedure call is the basis for cross-protection domain calls. So here is a protection domain, a file system. Here is another protection domain, the storage module. And if the file system has to get some service out of the storage module in order to serve the original request from the application process, that communication is implemented as a protected procedure call. And going across hardware address spaces minimally involves flushing the TLB of the processor in order to make room for the TLB entries of the domain that we're entering. And we will talk about that in a little bit more detail shortly. But the key point is there is an explicit cost involved in going from one address space to another address space, and that is the second strike against a microkernel-based design. The third strike against microkernel-based design is the cost for doing thread switches. These thread switches have to be mediated by the kernel. If the file system needs to make a protected procedure call to the storage module in order to complete an application level request for an operating system service, that involves the file system having to be mediated through the microkernel in order to go and execute some functionality in the storage module. So that involves a thread switch, an IPC, in order to do that. So in other words, the basis for protected procedure call is thread switches and inter-process communication, which has to be mediated through the kernel. And this kernel mediation can be expensive. That is, thread switches and inter-process communication can be expensive. That's the third strike against a microkernel. So all of these three strikes that I mentioned are explicit costs associated with providing an application level service in a microkernel based operating system, because the application has to first make a request to the microkernel. Microkernel may have to pass that request on to server processes that are living above the microkernel, and the server processes may have to talk to one another, and this protected procedure call itself has to be mediated by the microkernel via thread switching and inter-process communication. And in addition to all of these explicit costs, there could be a fourth cost, which is the implicit cost. And this is due to the memory subsystem and the loss of locality that can happen when we are going across address spaces. And when the file system makes a protected procedure call into the storage module, at that point, we are changing locality from the address space of the file system to the address space of the storage module. And therefore, the thread that starts executing inside the storage module may not find the cache warm, meaning the contents of the cache may not be reflecting the working set of the storage module that needs to get executed right now in order to satisfy the request coming from the file server. And this loss of locality can be both for address translation in the TLB, for this new address space that we are in, as well as for data and instructions that are contained in the cache. Both of those may take a hit because of the fact that we are going from one address space to another address space. That's the implicit cost of the locality loss. That would be the fourth strike against a microkernel-based design. all of these strikes against a microkernel-based design seems pretty solid. Now, how does L3 go about debunking the myths about microkernel-based design? Let's see that systematically.